In this example, we're given a preference table and asked several questions. Looking at the preference table, notice how the first row tells us the number of voters, while the second through fifth rows tell us the voters' first, second, third, and fourth choices. Looking at the choices, notice how the candidates are A, D, F, and G. First question is how many voters voted in this election, which would be the sum of this first row. So we have 11 plus 19 plus 10 plus 3 plus 2 plus 12 plus 4, which is equal to 61. So a total of 61 voters voted in this election. Next we're asked how many first place votes are needed for a majority. A majority is more than half, so we want to begin by finding half or 50% of 61. To find 50% of 61, we would convert 50% to a decimal, which is 0.5 or 0.50, then multiply by 61. This would give us 30.5. Of course, we can't have a fractional part of a vote, and also a majority is more than half, and therefore we have to round this up to 31. Therefore, 31 first place votes are needed for a majority. I do want to point out that if there were a total of 60 voters, half of 60 would be 30, but 30 would not be enough votes because we have to have more than half or more than 50%. So we still have to have 31 first place votes for a majority if there were only 60 voters. Next, which candidate or choice has the most first place votes? We can determine this by analyzing the first and second rows. Notice how candidate D received 11 first choice votes, but candidate A received 19 plus 10 plus 4 or 33 first choice votes. F received 3 plus 2 or 5, and G received 12. And therefore A received the most first place votes. Next we're asked which candidate or choice has the least first choice votes. Here we have to be a little careful because if a candidate did not show up here in this row, meaning they did not receive any first choice votes, that would be the candidate with the least first place votes. But every candidate does appear in this row, therefore every candidate did receive at least some first choice votes. Looking at candidate F, F received only 3 plus 2 or 5 first place votes, which is the least. So this would be candidate F. Next we're asked which candidate or choice had the most last place votes, which in this case would be the most fourth choice votes. So we'll analyze this row here. A received a total of 11 plus 2 or 13 fourth choice votes, but notice candidate D received 19 plus 10 or 29 fourth choice votes. G received 3 plus 4 or 7, and F received 12. So candidate D received the most fourth choice or last place votes. And then finally, which candidate or choice has the least last place votes? Again, if there was a candidate missing from this row here that gives us the fourth choice votes, that candidate would receive 0 fourth choice votes and therefore would be the candidate for this question. But again, every candidate does appear in this row. And notice candidate G receives 3 plus 4 or 7 fourth choice votes, and therefore G receives the least last place or fourth choice votes. I hope you found this helpful.